what are different types of solid. So basically solids are classified into two groups, group A and group B. Group A includes solid having top and base of same shape, and group B includes solids having base of some shape and just a point as a top called apex. Group A includes cylinder. So this is the cylinder, this is the base of the cylinder, this is top of the cylinder, which is circular in shape. Another type of group A solid, it is prisms. Again, there are different types of prisms: triangular prism, square prism, pentagonal prism and hexagonal prism. For triangular prism, this is the base and this is the top, which is triangular in shape, and this is equilateral triangle, and there will be three vertical rectangular faces. For a square prism, base and top, it is square in shape, and there will be four vertical rectangular faces. For pentagonal prism, base and top, it is regular pentagon, and there will be five vertical rectangular faces. For hexagonal prism, base and top, it is regular hexagon, and there will be six vertical rectangular faces. Next type of group A solid, it is cube. Cube is the solid having six square faces. For square prism also, there are six faces. Only difference is, for cube, all six faces are equal in size and which is square in shape. In group B, first type of solid, it is cone. This is the base of the cone, here it is the apex. Another type of group B solids, it is pyramids. Again, pyramids are classified into different types: triangular, square, pentagonal and hexagonal. Now what is the difference between prism and pyramid? Let us consider triangular prism and triangular pyramid. For triangular prism, base and top are triangular in shape, whereas for triangular pyramid, base it is triangular and at top there is apex. Another difference is, for prisms there will be vertical rectangular faces, and for pyramids there will be vertical triangular faces. For triangular prism there will be three vertical rectangular faces, and for triangular pyramid there will be three vertical triangular faces. Remember, these vertical triangular faces are isosceles triangles. Base of triangular pyramid, it is equilateral triangle. Another type of pyramid, it is square pyramid, where base is square in shape, and there will be four vertical isosceles triangles meets at a point called apex. For pentagonal pyramid, base is regular pentagon and there will be five vertical triangular faces which meets at a point called apex. So this is the apex of the pentagonal pyramid. Next is hexagonal pyramid. So base is regular hexagon and there will be six vertical triangular faces which meets at a point called apex. Next type of group B solid, it is tetrahedron. Tetra means four. Tetrahedron is a solid having four triangular faces. For triangular pyramid also, there are four triangular faces. So difference between triangular pyramid and tetrahedron is, in tetrahedron, all four triangles are equilateral triangle of same size. For cube also, as there are six faces of equal size, it is also called as hexahedron. Hexa means six, tetra means four. This is three-dimensional view of tetrahedron. Now we will see the dimensional parameter of different solids. So let us consider four types of solid: square prism, square pyramid, cylinder and cone. For square prism, this is the top surface, this is the rectangular face, this is the longer edge, this is the corner of the base, this is the edge of the base, this is the base surface. For square pyramid, this is the apex, this is the slant edge, this is the base surface, this is the edge of the base, this is the corner of the base and this is the triangular face. For cylinder and cone, there are curved surface. So, the imaginary lines which generate the curved surface is called generators. So, these are the generators of cylinder and cone. For cylinder, this is the base. For cone, this is the apex and this is the base surface. Now we will solve one problem based on projections of square prism. So question is, draw the projections of square prism, base 25 mm side and axis 50 mm long, resting on one of its base edge on HP, with the axis inclined at 45 to HP and resting edge inclined to VP at 30 degree. So this problem is based on projection of square prism. So this is a square prism, where this base and top, it is square in shape and there will be four vertical triangular faces. Let us assume the corners of top surface, it is A, B, C, D and corners of the base square, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. As per given problem, base is the 25 mm side. So this edges of base square and top square will be 25 mm long and axis is 50 mm long, means its height will be 50 mm long. It is mentioned that resting on one of its base edge on HP. These are the edges of the base, that is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. Out of these 4 edges, one edge will be resting on HP. So let us consider edge 3, 4, it is the resting on HP. So in first stage, we have to keep this base surface on HP. And at this 3-4 edge is the resting edge. So we have to keep this base surface on HP in stage 1. And its orientation will be such that as this 3-4 it is the resting edge, this edge will be on right hand side and perpendicular to XY. So in first stage, top will be the square and front will be the rectangle. Now while drawing the top view, when we are looking from the top, point A and point 1 will be coinciding, point B and point 2 will be coinciding, point C and point 3 will be coinciding, point D and point 4 will be coinciding. So draw XY line and draw the top view. So top will be the square in shape. So draw the square of 25 mm side and while drawing, that resting edge we have to take on right hand side and perpendicular to XY. So this is the top view. Give its name. So point A and 1 will be coinciding, point B and 2 will be coinciding, point C and 3 will be coinciding, points D and 4 will be coinciding. Take the projections of each point in the front view. And it is mentioned that axis is 50 mm long, means height of this prism will be 50 mm. For top surface, we are considering ABCD and for bottom 1, 2, 3, 4. Further, it is mentioned that resting on one of its base edge on HP with axis inclined at 45 to HP. Now this is the axis of the prism. This axis and this side, it is parallel. So when we incline this axis at 45 to HP, this side will be also inclined at 45. And we have considered that this 3-4 edge, it is resting edge. So this 3-4 edge will be always on XY in the front view. So in second stage, we have to make this axis at 45 to HP. So we have to redraw this front view such that this axis will be inclined at 45 to XY. Now in stage 1, this axis is inclined at 90 degree to HP. If we rotate this in clockwise direction, then automatically this axis will become 45 degree to HP. Now while drawing second stage, we have to keep in mind that this 3-4 edge will be on XY. So draw the second stage front view. Here this angle, it is 45 degree. Now here we have to draw the top view. To draw the top view, take the vertical position from each points from the front view and horizontal position from the previous top view, like this. And give the names. This is the position of 1 and this is the position of 1. So here we will get 0.1. As this top will be modified, we will change its name. So 0.1 will become 1 1, 0.2 will become 2 1, 0.3 will become 3 1, 0.A will become A1, 0.B will become B1, like this. So to locate 0.1, this is the position of 1 from the front view and this is the position of 0.1 from the top view. So here we will get 0.1. This is also position of 0.2 and this horizontal position of 0.2, here we will get 0.2. This 3 3, so here we will get 0.3. similarly, this is the position of A and this is the position of A, so here we will get 0.A. so in this we look at all points. Now to draw the lines, we have to look from the top. So when we look from the top, this edge 3 4, it is not visible, so it will be dotted like this. This is the second stage. Now we have to draw the third stage, and in third stage it is mentioned that the resting edge is inclined to VP at 30 degree. 3 4, it is the resting edge. In second stage, the inclination of this resting edge is 90 degree to vertical plane, and we have to make this inclination 30 degree. Now see here, length of 3 4 in first stage and length of line 3 4 in second stage is the same, and it is true length, so it is not required to calculate beta angle. Again, this 3 4 and 2 1, it is parallel. So when we make this 3 4 line at 30 degree, this 2 1 will be also at 30 degree. So for convenience, I will take inclination of this 2 1. So here to draw the third stage, we have to draw a line at 30 degree to XY. So inclination of line with VP will be reflected in top view. So here we have to draw a line at 30 degree, like this. So this is 30 degree line, and on this 30 degree line we have to take this object. So we will rotate this object in clockwise direction, and we will keep this 1 2 line on this 30 degree, like this. Now to give the names, let us start from this point. So here this is the point 1. Go along clockwise direction. The next point in clockwise direction is 2 1. So here it is 2 1 point. Next point is 3 1. So here we will get 3 1 point. Next point it is B 1. So here we will get B 1. Then next is C 1. Then next is D 1. Then A 1. 4 1 and again 1 1. So in this way we can give the names. Now next step is we have to draw the front view here. To draw this front view, take the projections from latest top view and latest front view. So take the vertical position from the top view and horizontal position from the latest front view, like this. Now to locate the point, let us observe the vertical position of 1 is this and horizontal position of 1 is this. So here we will get 0.1. Then to locate second point, this is the position of 0.2 from the top view and this is the position of 0.2 from the front view. Here we will get 0.2. Then 3 point, this is the vertical position of 3 and horizontal position of 3 is XY. So here we will get 0.31 dash. Then 4, this is vertical position of 0.4 and this is the horizontal position of 0.4. So here we will get 4 point. Then next is A. So this is the vertical position of A and this is the horizontal position of A. So here we will get A point. Then B. So this same line, it is the position of B and this is the vertical position of point B. So here we will get point B. Similarly, here we will get C and this is the D. So here we will get D point. So in this way we have located 8 points. Now we have to draw the lines. To draw these lines we have to look from this direction. Now this corner 2, it is away from the observer. Observer is here on this side. And when we look at this object from this side, point 2, it is away from the observer. And line passing from the 2, that is 1, 2 and 2, 3 will be not visible when we look from this. So line passing from 2 will be dotted, whereas this D point, it is nearest to the observer and all lines passing from that point will be visible. While deciding the which will be the dotted line, remember that all outside edges will be dark and lines which is passing from the point which is away from the observer will be always dotted. While deciding the dotted line, you have to remember two things. First is all outer edges will be dark and this is the point away from the observer. So lines passing from that point may be dotted. While drawing line, you have to observe the first stage. In first stage, there is line between AB, BC, CD, DA and 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1. And vertical line is in between A to 1, B to 2, C to 3 and D to 4. So you have to draw all these lines in this view. All outer edges will be dark. First we will draw all lines and then we will decide which will be dotted and which will be dark. And the point D, it is near to the observer. So all lines passing from this, that is AD, DC and D4, these will be dark lines. Make this line dark. And point 2, it is away from the observer. All lines passing from that point will be the dotted lines. So see here, 2, 3, 1, 2 and B2 will be dotted. So make those lines dotted. And all outer edges will be dark. Like this. So this is the stage 3. So in this way, we have drawn projections of solids in three stages. In stage 1, always we have to draw true shape of the base. If it is resting on HP, then top view will be the true shape. If it is resting on VP, then true shape of the base will be appear in the front view. In second stage, one of the view will change its orientation. So here front view changing its orientation and automatically top view will be changing. And in third stage, again one of its view will change its orientation. So in this way we have drawn projections of square prism.